I think in the beginning it's fun to realize, well, I can't even take the bus. I'm so stupid. I can't make a pay phone call. I just have to learn these things. But there's a lot more subtle things that go into the cultural transition period. And that loss of power, not being able to predict other people's behavior, wears you down over time. And that is a stress. And that stress builds up like any long-term stress does. And that is what we call culture shock. Yep.
Something familiar can begin to take over.
Of course, when you first arrive in another society, there's the initial period of the newness and the surprise, and so it's extremely exciting and exhilarating, that first period of time. Then, I think probably the roughest time is, I would say, after perhaps 6 weeks in a society or 5 weeks in a society, the newness has, you've seen the newness. Then you may begin to become homesick, to think of your own culture. You yet haven't had an opportunity, because it's so early in your experience, to form really deep friendships with other people. So you begin to feel the loneliness. So I think that's a pretty crucial time, about six weeks into the experience, where there may be these initial feelings of culture shock, loneliness setting in.
I was kind of scared. Sometimes I didn't know if I was doing the right decision. I was always afraid of, I don't know what, afraid of nothing, I think. It was a new experience, learning how to take a decision and learning if you were doing it right or not. I know that many times I made mistakes. I didn't know if I was doing it right or not.
I wasn't too happy about having to come out here. It was my dad who sort of pushed it. I guess the reason why I was afraid of coming out here was the idea of having to leave my family, my friends, my way of life, and start all over again in a totally different land.
Everything was traumatic in its own way. Going to the post office, trying to communicate in German that you want your letter mailed home, or having to, wanting to send a package home and someone saying, well, you have to fill out these four forms first. And looking at the forms and thinking, oh, what does this mean? How do I fill these out? And doing it. And I guess what I learned very quickly was to laugh at a lot of things. It's hilarious when you go somewhere and you just sort of, you don't know what you're doing, and you have to work doubly hard to get people to understand you and to understand them. And so I guess I got an attitude very quickly of just don't take it that seriously.
I reacted to everybody smiling to me. Everybody smiled. Everybody was so friendly, and I felt everybody was looking at me and smiling right in my face, and I never experienced that before, because you don't do that in Norway. You don't look anybody in your eyes. You don't say hello to people you don't know. And suddenly all these people were so friendly and nice to me. And I thought, God, everybody's going to like me a lot. But then as time passes by, I realize that it's not particularly true. Maybe they're just polite, or actually most of them are just polite. So that was very confusing to me, all that niceness, all these smiles. I couldn't get my mouth working to smile so much.
During Christmas, after I'd been there for 4 months, and I was really, I had established some friends and I was feeling pretty good, and my folks sent me over a Christmas card, and it had a picture of my family all waving at me and saying, we miss you. And it was right before Christmas, and it just really tore me up. And emotionally, it was a low for me, being away from my family for the first time in my life.
Students suffering from feelings of isolation and loneliness for too long a time can suddenly wind up in serious trouble.
I did drugs. I shouldn't have done it, but I wanted to do it. Why did I do that? Because I was depressed. I thought that nobody cared for me. Then when I started to smoke pot, and then when I started to, going into drugs, you know, one friend told me that it wasn't worth it, and she said, look at yourself. So that's what I did, and one time I looked at myself in the mirror and I said, this is not worth it. I had to go back to school, and I had to get things done.
In a new country, though sometimes difficult, is a good way to develop a support system and to feel more comfortable in a strange environment.
Being at home, you're so used to being with family and people you know, but once you step away, it's like you have to start all over again, and that's kind of difficult until you get the right circle of friends that you can fit into. I guess I had to be the one to step out. That was one of the major differences between making friends here and making friends at home. At home, people are so ready to take you in. That's one of the things that I missed. If any interest arose from people here, it was more like just curiosity, you know. And after they find out who you are and where you're from, they want to take off, you know. So it had to be more on my part, being persistent and being around people I thought to make good friends.
At first, I was just myself. And I found that hard to get myself into the American groups of friends, because no matter, well, the differences were so clear that it was just like mixing oil and water, that you know, things don't go well, you see. And I was initially very down. I felt isolated. I felt strongly that the American friends of mine are not cooperating, you see. And I tried to change my way of life a little bit, and I started doing things that I think would be able to help me to get into the group. Things like, you know, I started drinking a little bit, and I started pretending to be an American, which later on I know that wasn't what I should have done, you see. I mean, that didn't help much at all. So later on, I came and thought about it and said, why not I just be myself? And if they like me, sure. If they don't, too bad. You know, I can only be myself, you see. I mean, I would be more satisfied being myself. And if, you know, see if I can get into the group. And I did. I mean, I tried to be myself. I exposed myself a little more to the people and let them know what kind of a person I actually am. And, you know, just give myself a chance to go out there and mix around. Do things like sports. Do things like getting into group activities. Get things like international students. Things like... just go to party and get to know more people and be yourself.
So I learned just as much, if not more, out of class as I did in class. Going to the supermarket, getting together with friends, and that's when it really started getting interesting, actually. When we could compare, I got as much out of the conversations as my European friends, because we both learned about each other's system.
At I've had a lot of good times, a lot of good times. I can look back and say, boy, I'm glad I did whatever I did. You know, just jump into a car and just all of you drive off someplace and have a picnic or little things, you know. Have friends over at home and roast some chicken, give them some tea to drink. Just sit back and talk, you know. Just those are the kind of things that I really enjoy, just having people around me and interacting with them.
Foreign students coming to the United States sometimes express difficulty in breaking through the cultural borders and making friends with Americans.
If you're an American student, you're very busy with your own studies, you have your own friends, and you don't have your own social networks. It's just easy to stay within your own comfortable network. And if you come here and you're part of a very large foreign student community, you're part of a large group of Indonesians or part of a large group of Chinese students, it's very easy to spend time with people of your own cultural background. Then you don't have to make those adjustments. There are those students, both American and from other countries, however, who take that step, that additional step, and really try to cultivate friendships with students from many different nations. And those students, by the time they finish the University of Oregon, will have had a really enriched educational experience because they have made the effort to get to know students from Japan, from Korea, from Belgium, from South Africa, from very Latin American countries that we have represented here on this campus. It's an incredibly rich cultural environment if the individual is willing to take that initiative to become, try to form friendships with people from other societies. And that applies both to the Americans and the students from other countries.
For me, I mean, I haven't really experienced any difficulties dealing with Americans just because I've always been in a university atmosphere and university environment. But when I go out of this area, when I go to the real world, you know, when I talk to real Americans, I see that there's still a lot of prejudice and against foreigners, and they don't really they don't really like to deal with foreigners that much, maybe because they don't know much about other cultures.
I really think Americans are quite nice. I mean, there are some nasty ones, there are some very nice ones. It's just your chance, you see, to open up and, I mean, don't close yourself up just because you think they're all that way, you know. Open yourself up and you will hit some bad ones, you will hit some good ones, but you will hit some good ones, you see, and that will make you feel better. I'm sure it will.
Trying to fit into a new culture isn't always easy for anyone. Americans studying in other countries often experience problems, too.
When people heard that I was from America, it conjured up a whole bunch of prejudices. I could see it in their faces. She has money. She's over here for a good time. And, you know, visions of Dynasty or Dallas, if you were in a country that aired that. Or just rich tourists parading through their countries, not knowing what they're looking at.
Becomes more familiar and the habits of its people seem less strange, many students gain a new perspective and start to look at their home culture differently.
Of course, when you leave your country and when you're exposed to new cultures, you realize the problems with your own culture, and that's when you start learning about your own culture. And I was really critical in after 2 years, you know. I was I didn't agree with a lot of things that we had as a part of our culture, because a lot of times they didn't make sense to me anymore, and they weren't really logical. I can't accept all the customs they have and all the traditional beliefs, their traditional beliefs.
One of the stages of culture shock and cultural awareness is kind of a denigration of your home culture. And I know a lot of students go through that. Well, no culture is all good and no culture is all bad. It's just they're different. And you want to get to that point where you can see it objectively and see the good points about any culture.
I've never felt proud to be an American. I felt lucky to be an American. And I really felt lucky last year when I saw a lot of the different countries and how what we do have. By luck, our natural resources, our government, the space we have to live in, things like that.
We say culture shock is very positive because you're so much wiser about yourself and your culture and everything else once you've gone through it. It's not a comfortable period, but it is what I consider to be a very positive period in a person's life.
Foreign students often find themselves the center of attention, as curious people bombard them with questions about their home. By sharing stories about themselves, foreign students may find they have as much to offer their host country as they have to take.
I think what foreign students can bring here is at least spark an interest in learning about other cultures. Americans are as smart as anybody else if they take an interest in something. But I think to spark an interest in them is what we'd like a lot of international students. Interacting with an international student can spark an interest in learning more and wanting to achieve maybe the same level of personal growth that these students are experiencing when they're coming here.
And the whole sentence here reads, من از اینکه امروز در اینجا هستم خیلی خوشحالم. I'm very glad to be here today.
I'm in a program called the International Cultural Service Program, and we just go to different schools, elementary, middle, or high schools, and we talk about our own culture, about our own countries, and we just think Americans should start learning about different cultures, and they should broaden their perspective.
Want to say it after me? Salam.
Salam. Salam.
That was very good. That means hello. Okay.
They like it a lot, and I enjoy it myself too a lot. They ask very, very good questions. They always ask me to come back and give some more presentations, and they seem to enjoy it a lot, and I'm happy about it.
And it's like it's a blessing every time you step out and you talk to them and they ask you all these questions because you realize they want to know. It's enriching both ways. Before I used to get angry when somebody asked me, do you wear clothes? I'd think, oh my God, you know, how can they ask me such a question? But after a while, I got used to the idea and I thought, they really want to know. You know, if I was home, I would be curious. So I started letting myself enjoy the questions and, you know, answer them as honestly and as, you know, as clearly as possible. It makes you more aware of who you are and where you're coming from. That's one of the, you know, the biggest things I've learned about the program. It makes me feel so proud to say I am who I am, and I am glad that I come from where I come from.
After spending some time in a new culture, many students experience changes in themselves, which can make returning home as difficult as it was to leave.
Well, the return home, the re-entry culture shock, is kind of an unexpected surprise. The research says it is, in fact, more intense than the initial culture shock they experienced here. I think once you become an internationalist, once you've gone through culture shock and seen your culture kind of objectively, you do go through this kind of a conversion experience where you see things more objectively, and you're on the mountain and you're looking down. So you're going back into your country. Many students are coming here from very traditional countries, and it's not easy for them to get back into a society that has certain expectations of them. They have changed. The country has not changed and will put certain pressures on a student. And what we try to do is make students aware of both culture shock and the return culture shock, because they will cope better with the problem if they know more about it.
I have been through changes. Like, I realized when I went back home this Christmas that I had been through changes. I had grown. I'd become more open-minded, more broad-minded. Whereas at home, my friends are still on that same train of thought. You know, I can sit down and discuss anything. Whereas there's some issues at home where I cannot, it would be wrong for me to even start talking. Take, for example, family planning. You know, you don't discuss such things in the open. Those are very hush-hush kind of subjects that you just don't talk about. Whereas here, I'd freely do it and feel there's absolutely nothing wrong with it.
I used to feel very Norwegian when I first came here, and I wanted to go home and do all the Norwegian things, to eat Norwegian and dress Norwegian and speak Norwegian. But now it's just like I'm like in an in-between land. I'm not so Norwegian anymore. And when I go back there, I don't feel American either. I'm somewhere in between. I think that's what's happening. You get international or something.
I can change from one person to another person without actually changing who I am. Because I have, it's like I'm two people now. But it all boils down to one person, you see. So if I'm in one place, I behave like another person. If I'm in another place, I behave like another person. But actually, the two come together as myself. So that's, I think that's kind of neat.
Sometimes hard, but it's always an adventure. There are some tips that might help the transition go a little smoother. One thing students who have studied in a different culture have plenty of is advice to new foreign students on how to make the experience more enjoyable.
Be what you are. Don't try and be somebody else. Don't try and be like the people here. You know, just be yourself. That's the easiest role to play. And if you're accepted, fine. If you're not, you know, it's not your loss. I think it's their loss.
There's one thing that I would like to point out is that never forget, you know, the way you were. I mean, coming here is a positive experience for me. I mean, I've learned a lot of things that I've never learned before. And there are some things I've always wanted to learn. But there are some times when I tend to forget, you know, the way life used to be back there. And those were not negative things. Those were things that you should keep in mind all the time.
Keep your sense of humor would be number one. And don't be afraid to ask questions. You don't know what's going on in this country, and so accept that and don't be shy. I think a lot of people are feeling like, I'm the only person that is having this problem, and so they keep it to themselves. So one of the things that we try to say is, everybody went through it here once in the beginning, and I think everybody feels the same way, like, gosh, everybody else seems to know what they're doing and I don't. And if you do something silly, be ready to laugh at yourself and not get too awfully embarrassed by it.
They should live in the dormitories for 1 year at least to really learn the American life and to deal with Americans. Because I know a lot of foreigners who come here and get an apartment the first year, and they find another foreign roommate, and they just don't learn. They're so isolated, you know. They don't learn about the American life. I mean, we're not here just to study maybe biology or math, you know. We're here to learn different cultures too, and it'll be easier to deal with Americans in daily life too, if you know what their lifestyle is like, you know. So I would definitely suggest that they should live in the dormitories, even though it might be hard for them.
Do everything you possibly can when you're over there. Don't just study. Don't just be around people from your own country. be adventurous and don't be afraid to make mistakes. And don't be afraid to have people laugh at you a little bit. Because once you ask for that letter to be mailed home and don't understand how to write the instructions or whatever you're doing, it'll get better the next time. And I saw too many people who went over there and didn't do those things, didn't challenge themselves, and didn't grow very much either.
You're here and you have to get used to the, you know, the situation. You said, well, everybody else have done it, why not me? So you get courage and you do it. You just learn how to do it. Sometimes you make wrong decisions and you say, well, maybe next time will be better.
To avoid things like groups that get into, you know, smoking pot and getting involved with, you know, women and getting into bars and then totally forgetting what you came out here for. Because I've seen that very many foreign students get into that. And before you know it, they're out of school, you know. They've lost what they came out here for. They can no longer see the goal. And when you come out here as a foreign student, it's so important. You're representing so many people at home, you know, your family, your relatives, your friends. It's like you're a representative of a small country, you know, all your relatives and everybody. It's like you've come to represent the country.
It's going to be a natural instinct to fight going into another culture and hanging on to your previous values, because you are changing from one value system to another. And the sooner that you are more acceptant of different ways of doing things, the quicker you adapt to your new culture and you'll be able to enjoy it that much quicker.
The way life really is over here is that sometimes you tend to be very lonely. You're isolated. You're all on your own. Nobody close to you is over here. You are just there. I mean, you're there for a reason. You're there to study. You're there for education. But being lonely is not something that you can't handle. There's something that you take as a challenge to go out and make something out of it. So sometimes I tend to be lonely. Sometimes I tend to be, you know, a little sad. But instead of staying home and be more sad, I'd go out there and try to get rid of it.
I think students also should not feel at all shy to ask questions, if they are having any kind of difficulties or problems. There is a tendency sometimes, in particularly some cultures, to be very reticent and shy about going to someone else with a problem. And I think a student should not hesitate. If they are feeling lonely or if they're having any kind of difficulties, they really should seek out other friends, seek out the Office of International Student Services, talk to their professors.
Whether you're a foreign student coming to the United States or an American going abroad, life in a new country will present many challenges, but the opportunities are abundant for you to grow from the experience and to share yourself with others who are curious about you and the country you come from. Opening yourself to others, observing and learning from the situations you are involved with, will ensure an experience you will value the rest of your life.
I like to tell foreign students that they are special, and the main reason is that people who are willing to leave family and friends behind and go to another country where they really don't know what kind of experiences they're going to get involved in are taking a challenge and a risk, and they're doing it in the sake of personal growth and development. And those are the type of people that I am certainly eager to help.
I think anyone who goes abroad, anyone who says it was just a wonderful time is not telling the truth. There were lower points than I've ever had in my life and higher points than I've ever had in my life. And so I look at the combination of the two, and that's how I look at the year.
Being a foreign student out here is hard. You just have to know the right things to do, the right people to mix with, the right subjects to take, the right major to choose, you know, and the whole list. So I tell them, you know, choose the right things.
Maybe we should just try to treat each other as people and not as Americans and foreigners. You know?
I think more people that understand people from other countries, the better chances that we have on this planet for world peace. If I get to know a Soviet, I'll realize that it's not him individually that we should have a problem with, but it's a lot more governmental than people-to-people type of programs.
I guess I feel like home is wherever you are, and you sort of carry it with you.